Hi friends, welcome to UFA Studies YouTube channel. This is part 33 in Azure Data Factory real-time scenarios playlist. In this video, I am going to discuss how you can load a CSV file into JSON file with a nested hierarchy using Azure Data Factory. And especially we are going to use mapping data flows for this purpose to generate that nested hierarchies inside the JSON. So I will practically explain you the requirement first, and then I will explain you the how to practically implement that as well. So this is my Azure portal. If I go to my ADLS Gen2 account, which I have in my Azure portal, let me show you the CSV file first. So here, let me go to containers. Under there is a container called ADF demo here. So let's wait for the page to load here. So under this ADF demo container, if I go to data folder, there is a file called customer-purchases.csv file. So let me open this CSV file and let me show you the content of this file in practical. So let me hit this edit button. If you see here, this file contains customer ID, customer name, item name, quantity. So all these are like a purchase information. So customer called Mahir purchased laptop, mobile, keyboard, and this is the quantity. So 15 laptops, 20 mobiles, 15 keyboards. And if you see, there is another customer called Wafa who purchased a monitor, which are like 5 quantity. So 5 monitors he purchased. So this is the data we have, let's assume. Now we want to convert this data like this. If you see this JSON here, we have a customer ID. So from here to here, one customer information. Okay. So customer ID, customer name, and we generated a array called purchases. Inside that array, we have a objects called item. For each item, what item he purchased and how much is the quantity. So see, all these objects came together as an array under purchases key and customer ID, customer name. So this is how we want to generate our JSON once we load that CSV file. So how to do that? How to get this kind of JSON out of this kind of CSV file using ADF, using mapping data flows? So let me go to my Azure Data Factory. ADF Mahir is my data factory. And here, if I go to author menu, so first thing is we should have a data set for our file. So let me create a new data set. So my data set, it is inside the ADLS Gen2 account, right? So let me select ADLS Gen2 connector here. Let me hit continue. So my file is CSV file, right? So let me select CSV connect format here and let me hit continue. So let me give a name, maybe like customer purchases. So this is what my file data set name. So let me create a new data linked service for my storage account. And let me select my subscription, and also let me select my storage account here. And then let me hit this test connection to test whether I am able to successfully connect with my ADLS Gen2 or not. So since here we are connecting with the account key, there should not be any error. See, connection successful. Let me hit create button. So this is going to create a linked service for my ADLS Gen2 account. And then here now we need to browse a file to which we want to point using this data set. So under ADF demo container data folder, so there is a file called customer-purchases.csv. Let me select that. So in that file, first row is header, right? If you remember, see here, our first row in the file is actually header. So we have selected that and let me hit OK. So this is going to create a data set for my file. This is the first step. So once we create a data set, then we can go ahead and add this data set inside the data flows. So let me create a new data flow here and make sure you enable this data flow debug option if you want to test your transformation in the middle of the execution. Okay, so I have enabled it to show you in practical. So let me add this source here and I am going to name it like cust purchases source. And here I am going to select my data set which is pointing to my file. If I go to projection here, you can see customer ID, customer name, item name, quantity, everything came correctly. So what I can do, I can perform the data preview as well to make sure I am getting my data properly into this source transformation or not. So let's wait for the fetching data to happen here. It will take 10 to 15 seconds. Great. See, we got customer ID, customer name, item name, quantity. All fine. Now, what we want? We want this kind of JSON out of it, right? So always, whenever you try to convert your data into JSON, make sure you see all the nodes of your JSON properly. And I try to identify the innermost node. So if you see here, inside this entire JSON object, my innermost node is this one, like item name, quantity. So these are the innermost items or innermost keys. Okay, so this should become as an object. Okay, so all this is one object, this is one object. So these two columns should become as one JSON object. and with a complex type of purchases. See, under purchases we have item name and quantity. Of course we have it as an array, but for now ignore the arrays and try to consider them like purchases is a key which is a complex type under which we have item name and quantity. So we should build a complex type like this purchases, and underneath that we should have a item name quantity. So once you build that complex type, then you can convert that into array as well, like how you are seeing right now. So first let's build this complex type. So purchases, under that item name quantity, right? So to do that, what I am going to do, I am going to add a derived column transformation here. So what every transformation will do, I have explained that already in my ADF playlist, so please watch them if you haven't seen that. Okay, so under derived column transformation I am going to build purchases complex type. Okay, so I named it like that, and here I am trying to add a new column on top of my data called purchases, and let me open expression builder, and in the expression builder I am going to make sure to write all these subtypes like item name, quantity, everything. Okay, so let me go to my ADF. So here, right, so under purchases, so this is the expression builder what we opened from the derived column. If you remember, see here, for the purchases we clicked this open expression builder to open the expression builder. So here under purchases, hit this plus button, add sub column. See, as I said, my item name and quantity are sub columns of the purchases key, right? So I am hitting this add sub column, and here, so item name is one sub column under purchases, and then another sub column, my another sub column name is quantity. Quantity is my another sub column. So two sub columns I added it. So under item name, what I should get? Under item name, I should get that item name column. Under quantity, I should get that quantity column, right? So what I am going to do, hit this item name, and here I should select from the input JSON whatever the value I am getting from the CSV item name column, place that here, then go to quantity. Let me hit this quantity, and here whatever the value I am getting from this quantity column of the CSV file, I should get that here. So let me hit this save and finish. Now if I go to inspect here, if you see the output JSON, if you see input first, from the source I am getting customer ID, customer name, item name, quantity. If you see the output, customer ID, customer name, all the columns from the source, plus a additional column called purchases, which is a complex type, and under that I should see the both the internal nodes like item name and quantity. See, everything is coming correctly. Now let me go to data preview and let me perform data preview and see whether we are getting that complex type object properly or not. Great, see, we got purchases complex object with item name and quantity. Okay, so now, but if you see the JSON of our file, see, this purchases object is a group by, right? So why I am saying group by? Because it is an array. So customer ID and customer name is same for all these three purchases. So that's why it is something like a group by on top of these two columns, then generate this array. Okay, so to do the same thing, I am going to use aggregate transformation. So here select the aggregate transformation, and here under group by, you need to group by this customer ID and customer name. So perform group by on these two columns, and then under aggregate, I am going to aggregate the values of this purchases complex type to generate a array like this. So I am going to aggregate all these three based upon group by of these two and generate a array out of it. So to do that, how to do that? Under expression builder of this aggregates purchases, you need to use a collection function there. See, for the purchases I am going to use a collection function. This collect function actually going to generate array out of your column values. So from my input schema, I am going to pass this purchases complex object. On that object I am using a collect function to generate a array. So let me hit this save and finish. Now if I go to inspect here, if you see here in my output JSON, customer ID, customer name, then item name, this purchases object came as an array here. See, observe this symbol, this is an array. So let me perform data preview also to show you that in practical, so that you will make sense of that array generation here. Great, see, array generated for customer ID 1 Mahir. If I see the purchases, all the three purchases. For customer ID 2, if I see, there is only one purchase, right? So that is what we have seen in our CSV file as well, right? If I show you the CSV file, see here, only one purchase for the customer 2 and three purchases for the customer 1. Okay, so that's it. So once you are done with this all this kind of transformation using this derived columns and aggregate functions, use sync transformation and then load your file in whatever the destination you want. So let me create a new data set here, same ADLS Gen 2 connector. and maybe I want to load it as a JSON file. And here I can select my storage account and let me browse the location where I want to place this JSON file. Maybe under ADF demo, under data folder only, I want to keep this customer purchases JSON. So let me hit this save button. So don't import any schema because there is no file at all. Go to settings here, and here file name option, select your entire output as a single file here. Click this set single partition, and here give a name, maybe like customer purchases dot JSON file, right? Okay, give that details. Go to mappings, disable this auto mapping, and make sure customer ID, customer name, this purchases object into purchases. Okay, so that's it. Now if you run this data flow, right, it should generate your JSON accordingly. So let me go here, let me create a new pipeline, and in this new pipeline let me drag and drop this data flow to execute it there. Let me hit this debug execute button here to execute my data flow using this data flow activity, and then let's try to examine the result in the storage account as well. Let's wait for the execution to complete. Here you can see right now our execution is in progress. Great, our pipeline execution is successful. Now if I go to my storage account, let me close this and let me refresh this, because under ADF demo data folder, that's where we generated our JSON file. If I go to this JSON file, cust purchases.json, let me hit this edit button, I should see my JSON accordingly. See, customer ID, customer name, purchases came as a array, and in that array we have objects like item name and quantity, another item name quantity, another item name quantity, right? If you see the second customer also, purchases is came as array, and only one purchase he did. See, this is how we can generate a complex JSON using a CSV file using data flows. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.